This is a short video about an ugly bug in Camtasia that's been lingering now since 1.1.1, and I'm running 2.2.0, so it's been years. So if you've got a Mac, you should never buy a Camtasia for Mac if you're doing any kind of Skype multi-person calls, because here's what happens. So here I've got Skype running here, and I've got the call recorder plug-in, and let's see, just check for updates. Okay, so the call recorder plug-in V2324. Now, call recorder is probably maybe the most used plug-in for Skype for recording calls. And I've got, here are the options that you can have for recording. I've got multi-track advanced turned on. Now, what that multi-track does is, if you've got two or more people in a call, then each video is on a separate track. Now, this makes it very easy to edit in smart software, unlike Camtasia, which is just stupid as a bag of hammer software. So here's what ScreenFlow looks like. Well, first off, if you can see this, let's see if I can get Finder running here. Let's look at the desktop. So if you look here in Finder, you can see that I've done a multi-track recording. Now, even Finder is smart enough to figure this out. So a stupid file browser can do this, and an expensive multi-hundred dollar piece of software like Camtasia can't. Come on, you guys in Camtasia Development, fix this darn thing. So if you look here, you got two tracks.
Alright, so today is Thursday, August 23rd, 2012.
Alright, one track is my side of the conversation. The other track is Sherry Strong, which is a person I'm interviewing. And if you look really closely here, you can actually see the side-by-side and even the thumbnail on Finder. Now let's see how smart ScreenFlow is. And we've got, let's check for updates. We don't need one. It's ScreenFlow 3.306. And we're going to, instead of doing recording, we're going to open an empty document. And we're going to drop this puppy in right here. Now, look at that. Is that smooth as glass? So you see the multi-channel recording side by side there? That is the way it's supposed to be. Now, let's look at the dumb as a bag of hammers Camtasia way of doing things. So we'll run Camtasia. And let's see here, so make sure we got, let's see, 2.2.0, let's see if we can go to their website here. Yeah, they don't even have a freaking link for their website. What is this? I think it's TechSmith, isn't that who does this? Yeah, TechSmith. And usually these guys are really good. Check for updates. We don't have any updates, so we got 2.2.0, and so, well, look at the bug, and then I'll see if they got an update. Now, here is the stupid bug. That instead of reading each track and showing each track as the separate correct stream. In other words, you got two streams here. Let's see. Let's bring up a copy of FFmpeg here to show what the internal structure of this document is. You guys at TechSmith ought to be smart enough to figure this out for sure. Okay, so we're going to go to the desktop here. Let's see, FFmpeg. Let's see what version we got here. Well, this is version 07.3.13, which is kind of old, but it'll do. FFmpeg input. All right. Now, if you look here, let's maybe make this a little bit bigger. Here's the internal structure of this file. Now, this brings up several problems that that Camtasia's got, and actually, I guess a little bit of a problem ScreenFlow has. It'd be really nice if when there was multi-track audio and multi-track video, that each one of the channels, whether it's audio or video, is on a separate track, and it's properly displayed, for God's sake. So here's an audio track. Here's the first stream is a 32-bit monophonic channel. The second stream is a 32-bit stereo channel. Now, really, to correctly normalize audio tracks, you ought to be able to, there's an option in Camtasia and ScreenFlow to separate video and audio. There ought to be an option to separate stereo into mono tracks, so that you can change the normalization, or you can normalize the levels of each one of the tracks separately. But here's the problem. So in a multi-track video, you've got, like, here's the first video stream is a 640 by 480. Second video stream is a 640 by 480. But what Camtasia is doing, which is just stupid, is that this thing here, let's see if I can show properties. It's probably going to say, well, where the heck does it say? Let's see, can we hit a crop or something? Okay, crop, let's see here. Well, you know, Camtasia is pretty stupid, because it should tell you the pixel count here. Let's see if we can get any kind of information out of brain dead Camtasia. Nope. Brain dead Camtasia doesn't do anything properly. In fact, it's even stupider, because see, I've been able to separate the two video channels, except they're fused together. In Camtasia 1 series, you could at least drag one video off the top of the other video channel and mess around with it and get it to work. Can't even do that anymore. That's broken beyond belief. So what should happen here is, instead of saying, so what Camtasia is doing, it's reading the first video stream and saying, okay, this video is 640 by 480. Nope. But somehow I've got two videos, so I'm going to somehow cram those in. I'm going to make both those crammed into a 640 by 480, which is stupid, because, for example, if you've got a PC end of a conversation that's 640 by 480, and you've got a Mac version on the other end, which has got the FaceTime 720p camera, which is going to be 1080 by what, 720, I think is what the 720p is. So in that case, what you should see is something kind of like this. You should see, you know, one side of the conversation is the 640 by 480. The other side of the conversation is going to be the 720p. So this is going to be SD, you know, 640, 480. This will be 720p. And then, of course, if you have, you know, three people in the conversation, you should see, you know, you should see one version up there, and you should see the other track over here, and then you should see the other track, you know, somehow down here. So in other words, each one of the video tracks should show up separately in the edit window, and you should be able to separate all the stereo channels. So come on, TechSmith guys, you know, get your freaking act together and get your software fixed.